The fourth planet is Mars. There is Mars. It is one of the most explored planets, as its atmosphere is not very violent. Mars has two moons, but they are not planets, just some pieces of rocks captured in its orbit. First one is Deimos. There is Deimos. So here is Deimos. It is probably part of the asteroid belt detached from the Hive. The other one is Phobos. There is Phobos. What is interesting is that if we spend one day on Mars, we will see Phobos passing through the sky three times, while Deimos pass just one. So, after Mars, there goes the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter. It is not considered a planet and often is neglected when studying the solar system. The asteroid belt is a living example how a planet failed to form in its natural way. The reason is believed to be the huge gravity of Jupiter. There is one notable dwarf planet in the asteroid ring, Ceres, the largest planetoid having a real round shape. We can just make a comparison with other planets. So, the fifth planet, excluding the asteroid belt, is Jupiter. It is a gas giant and is the biggest planet in the solar system. As it sounds, gas giants are mainly composed by gases, and only the core consists of rock or ice. Jupiter also plays a very important role for the life on Earth. With its huge gravity, it attracts space-traveling objects and do not allow them to reach other planets. Like all gas giants, Jupiter has a lot of moons. This is 67 objects are circling around it, and some of them are well-developed planets, like Io, Europe, Ganymede and Callisto. So we'll find them, at least the bigger one. There is Ganymede, diameter 5000 kilometers. And Callisto 4000. So Ganymede is actually the biggest moon in the solar system. I believe it is bigger than Pluto. Yes, Pluto's diameter is 2000 kilometers. This is 5. And let's see Mercury. Yes, it's bigger than Mercury. Ganymede. So let's place Europe. What is interesting for Europe is there probably may have life. well, I didn't see that correctly, but there is water under the ice on Europe, they say. And Io. Io is the planet with the most volcanoes. In the solar system. And there is 62 more objects that we may explore with another fun game, but not now. So, next planet, Saturn. It's another gas giant and is the is famous with its visible ring of space objects moving around it. It is 24 times bigger than Earth and have 62 natural satellites, some of them very small in size. The biggest moon of Titan is Titan, The biggest moon of Jupiter is Titan, the second largest moon in the solar system. So let's see, where's Titan? There it is, 5,000 kilometers. Let's place it and let's see some of the biggest moons of Saturn. Okay. We continue. The seventh planet is Uranus. There it is. It is 10 times bigger than Earth. And the biggest moon of Uranus is Titania, I believe is pronounced. And let's see some more. Oberon, Umbriel, Ariel and Miranda, one of Uranus natural satellites. So the next gas giant is Neptune. It has all 14 objects around it, and let's see, the biggest one should be Triton. There is Triton. And we reached the last of the the planets from the Neptunian category. So the planets after Neptune are called trans-Neptunian objects, and the first one, or the last planet in the solar system, is considered in the solar system, is Pluto. Well, what is interesting for Pluto? It has another planet around it, Chiron. Well, it is a double dwarf planet, as the as the latest discoveries show. The Pluto have a brother planet, Chiron. Pluto and Chiron are considered a binary planet because the barycenter of their orbits does not lie within either body. This means that they both look like circling each other. Pluto have another four natural satellites: Styx, Nix, Cerber and Hydra. The tenth planet considered in this fun astronomy game is the dwarf planet Haumea. It is not arrangeable, but it is in the Oort cloud, so in the outer part of the solar system. The planet has an ellipsoid shape and even have two moons. And the farmost planet is Sedna. There it is. We'll arrange it in a while. It is a minor dwarf planet in the outer reach of the solar system. Here, little is still confirmed about where did this planet came from or how was formed. Some of these distant space objects may as well be satellites for some of the gas giants. It takes a lot of years to see where actually one orbit leads, as some of them need more than hundreds or thousands years to complete one side cycle. For Sedna, she goes one time around the sun for 12,000 years. So 12,000 years, Earth years, for one circlet of Sedna around the sun. This is insane. So this planet hasn't completed even one cycle, while humans have evolved from Iron Age to modern times. And let's place it, let's take our knowledge level, and that was the lesson for today. I hope it has been fun.